Uganda is believed to have the largest onshore oil reserves in sub-Saharan Africa, but there are mounting concerns that an influx of petrodollars could lead to corruption. VOA's Paul Ndiho has that story.
Energy experts say Uganda will start producing crude oil this year, reaching peak production of 150,000 barrels a day by 2015. Some of the oil will be used for power production, but the bulk will be sold domestically and in the region. The government says the revenue will be used for infrastructure development. Uganda's President Yoweri Museveni is reaching out to international investors.
The oil industry in Uganda has potential of providing a lot of investment opportunities to oil companies and other related businesses. You are all welcome to invest in Uganda, to invest in this emerging industry. I'm confident that with these interventions, Uganda would be a good destination for investment in the mining, petroleum, and energy sectors.
Within Uganda, there have been concerns that the oil revenue sharing agreements between energy companies and the government have not been made public. Dr. Kizza Besigye, Uganda's leading opposition figure, says that this lack of transparency could lead to high levels of corruption and warns that some of the contracts may have to be renegotiated. Other critics say that Museveni, who has ruled for more than two decades and is standing for a fourth presidential term, will not tolerate a handover of power with petrodollars about to flow.
The secret contracts that have been negotiated with the current regime will have to be reviewed, because we don't know what they are. Will have to be reviewed, and a review can lead to any kind of outcomes. Could lead to a renegotiation. It could lead to cancellation. It could lead to any form of outcome, depending on what we find. We don't know. This country does not know what our leaders are negotiating on our behalf.
Last year, a Ugandan court dismissed a case that local NGOs had filed to compel the government to disclose the details of oil sharing agreements it signed with four companies. Tom Balemesa, an oil researcher and Peace Corps fellow, says that since the discovery of oil, expectations are high and life of ordinary people is being transformed in one of the remotest regions in western Uganda.
With the accent of oil, more people are coming in and more people are expecting to get a lot of benefits in terms of jobs.
Balemesa is also concerned that Uganda's local population would not be able to get jobs in the oil industry.
The idea of jobs is so complicated. First of all, we lack the skills. The oil industry is so high-tech, I should say. The little I've read about it is so high-tech. Then, well, people are talking about the small, medium enterprise developments. Yeah, those ones are there. But usually it will go to the people who have got the qualification.
Analysts say Uganda has the potential to produce as many as 200,000 barrels of oil per day. This would place Uganda among the top 50 biggest producers in the world and among the top 10 in Africa. Paul Ndiho, VOA News.